The microwave beam turns blood makers into a complete joke. Yeah. The microwave beam not only stops a blood maker's attack, it disables its shield permanently if you do it right. Now, we already know the beam is great to freeze possessed demons, shatter shields and kill spirits. But today I'm going to show you why the beam is truly an S tier mod, and hopefully you'll start using it more in your playthroughs. Before we continue, only a tiny percent of people who watch my channel are subscribed. So please hit that subscribe button because it helps me out a lot. It's absolutely free and you can always unsubscribe later. Enjoy the video. Oh, also I stream on Twitch at Lord Spankworthy. Alright, here we go. You ready? Watch this. The microwave beam turns blood makers into a complete joke. First, I'm going to show you how you can use the microwave beam to completely nullify a blood maker. Not just that, it lets you cancel the maker's attacks completely, and finally, you can break a maker's shield for good. Watch how again and again and again it simply does not allow an attack. Period. And when you break a maker's shield, it opens them up to lock-on rockets, PB rockets, SSG ballista, chain gun bullying, you name it. And also, glory kills. The microwave beam lets you freeze a blood maker cold in its tracks. So how do you use the microwave beam mod to bully the blood maker? Get in front of him, but not too close, because he will attack you if you get too close. Bait out his attack, and the moment he pops the attack, boom, freeze him and precision bolt his head. You can also permanently disable his shield by freezing him and going in for a blood punch, but that's kind of risky because his close range attack is very, very, very hard hitting. If you want to disable a shield permanently, microwave beam, go up close, blood punch. Instantly done. Don't forget, once you disable the blood maker shield, he's still a super heavy demon. So you'll have to do at least 2 lock-on rockets volleys, or you'll have to just hold the chain gun shield on him for a while before you can stun him or kill him. Of course, there are some risks to using the microwave beam. Like for example, if you try to use it while there's a lot of enemies around you, you will die. If you get too close while you're doing it, you will die. But that's not all the microwave beam can do. You've probably seen Under the Mayo's video about the microwave beam mod, and you know a lot of the stuff that it can do, but did you know it also works on those annoying turrets in the final Seraphim fight? Also, it works on the Seraphim. Just point your microwave beam at him and watch it drain the life out of him. Try it out, guys. Tell me how it goes. Drop a comment. Tell me what you thought of this. And here's a bunch of video of me using the microwave beam to completely destroy blood makers. And yeah, enjoy the video.